All right, this is on my French Yahoo page, and it's just PR fluff. But I find some interesting points in this article, and this is 10 points about what women don't like about men, you know, when they're dating. After the first date, you know, why doesn't she answer your calls if you call her back? These might be some of the reasons. I find some of these pretty valid. I really do. Tu es trop parfumé. Men who wear a lot of toiletries, which have a strong fragrance, it's really a big turnoff. I would advise against it. That's a good point. You know, you should be clean from head to toe, for sure. You know, these strong scents are, you know, I find them personally, they make my nose run. And here's something else. Men get very attached to women. They just keep coming back when it's clear that the interest isn't there. And I've had this problem over and over again in my life, you know. I tried never to have sex until the fourth or fifth date. It was really hard to get rid of men. Some of them would reappear every few years and literally just install themselves in my home. And I try to be a good hostess and, you know, have a bathrobe and slippers and stuff and make them comfortable. But then they would basically just ask for my keys or a set of their own keys. It was really disturbing. All right. Now, it's very early in the morning. And I'm smoking too much. Turn off your portable phone and never say, I have to take this call, it's important. Yeah, this happens to me a lot in business. And, you know, if you cannot inform people in advance or post a message that you won't be available, I really don't appreciate that. With the kind of work I do, it has to be with no disturbance. And I do not want to hear your portable phone ring at all. And I don't want you taking any calls. You know, really. I mean, forget it. I hate it. Don't talk about your mother and about how good her cooking is. I find also, I have met women who also make the mistake of talking about their family. We don't need to hear about your family. If your family is very important to you, arrange a face-to-face meeting. I had a friend in New York who was always talking about her brothers or her cousins and what they were doing, and it was a huge turnoff, even for me as a female friend. And she wondered why she could never have meaningful long-term relationships, but, you know, don't talk about the family. You know, if somebody's really important to you of your own family, if you meet a new important person, you can arrange a face-to-face meeting or something like that. Otherwise, just don't talk about them. It's a huge, huge turnoff. Stop criticizing everything. You know, this says, well, you know, if you go to a restaurant and the service is bad, you don't like the decor, there's too much salt in your food, the people nearby are speaking too loudly. Criticizing everything all of the time is really a bore. My second husband used to do that constantly. It was just, I can't believe I was with him for 12 years. What a jerk I am, you know. Also, watch your body odor. You know, it's you shouldn't be too heavily perfumed. I think you should just be clean. You know, if you have an odor, coffee breath, anything, it's just not nice for people, really. If you talk about your ex and how good she was, then the woman will wonder, well, why did you leave her then? You know, why did you leave her? If you had such a good wife or such a good girlfriend, and she was so intelligent, so beautiful, so generous, why did you leave her? You know, don't talk about that. You know, it may have been a stupid mistake on your part, but I would say don't bring it up, because it really makes women wonder about you. You know, if she was so great, what was the problem? You know, I mean, whoa. Also talking about how bad women are or can be, and how bad relationships can be, is a huge turnoff. Women are not looking for a victim or a loser or a depressed person. You know, enough said. Now this is interesting. I don't really understand this. If you go out on a dinner date and you only order the smallest, cheapest salad, and he goes for the menu, which is, you know, a multi-course meal, and doesn't offer to share it, that's really a sign of selfishness and lack of recognition. You know, I did this a lot when he was paying, when men were paying. You know, I would really order something small and inexpensive most of the time, not always. I mean, sometimes I would say, well, yeah, I'm going to go for it. Is that cool with you? I want everything. Can you pay for it, really? And instead of just splitting the bill, with a lot of guys, I would take turns dating and paying, and we would just do what we could afford. So, like, if I couldn't afford a big event or something, I would just have them over to my place and make them a nice meal. I would cook it myself, or we would do something cheap. And I was taken on a lot of cheap dates that I thought were charming. The guy was like, well, I'd really love to see you, but I have very, very little money, so, you know, let's just ride the subway. I want to show you this cool place, and I know where there's a bathroom at the end of it, you know, and I just want to spend some time with you and talk to you, but I don't have any money today. That was fine with me, you know. If I didn't want to go do that, I just said no. You know, I really did not need expensive dates. I had a nice boyfriend for years in New York. He was a tennis pro, and he made pretty good money, and we got along famously. And we would take turns double dating, but when it was his turn to take me out, he was so polite, he treated me so nicely, and I didn't have to have a penny on me. And he never did anything that I don't think that he couldn't afford. I mean, the evening was all on him. You know, he picked me up, he dropped me off, and we stayed friends for years. That was a great dating situation. Yes, we did have sex. I just really liked the way when I knew that he was taking me out, everything was going to be taken care of. He was going to look after everything for that evening or outing with me. And we had great times together. And we were in touch for like, whoa, more than 10, 15 years. Very, very nice guy. And we just did what one or the other could afford, you know. And I was very, very nice to him, and he really appreciated it. We just didn't love each other, but it was really fun dating. Very, very good friends. Talking about your sexual exploits. Never do this with a woman. And for women to do this with men, some of them like it. They find it a little bit spicy. But that's something for, I think, men to more keep to themselves and talk about with their friends, you know. I really learned this the hard way. Whenever a man would tell me about a terrific sexual experience he had, he usually ended up being, frankly, some kind of pervert. So this is what French PR is saying about why a first date could turn you off. You know, life is a mixed bag, and I've met some really bad men and some really terrible women. That is for sure. But I think that most of the points raised here are very interesting. And personally, I would like to add that I don't like men who snort their snot, who don't use a handkerchief, who have bad manners, who have inappropriate footwear or footwear in bad condition. I don't know. Also, for men and women both, I don't date women, but if I notice that something is seriously wrong with their teeth, I wonder, like if a lot of them are missing or something, I wonder why they're not dealing with it. I really do. It just looks very, very bad. It doesn't speak well of you. The hair doesn't bother me that much. You know, people might be a bit disheveled and be in need of a haircut or whatever. You know, it's not the end of the world. I don't mind if it's, you know, somebody has some stubble or something. But I care about manners a lot. And I appreciate people who quietly tell me if my manners are disturbing them. If I'm speaking too loudly or I'm not sitting up correctly or something like that. A lot of American men I find have really bad manners. I don't know what they're thinking. You know, I mean, it's a dating situation. You know, I won't even go on a date. Or I wouldn't. I don't date anymore, but like even a social thing for meeting with a girlfriend or something here, not that I have that many friends here in France, but unless I can, you know, pull myself together and be pretty much in form, I call it off. I just say I'm not up to it. You know, I don't want to make them uncomfortable. I want to make them feel that they are important, that I could at least, you know, clean myself up and make sure that my clothes are decent. And I mean, you know, if you don't have money or are very frugal or stingy and you don't like to wear fine things or makeup or good clothes, that doesn't bother me at all. But, you know, if I see sneakers on a guy, or a woman, in fact, for that matter, and they haven't been jogging or doing sports, or if they didn't ride their bicycle over to see me or something, I just don't find that appropriate. You know? I mean, sneakers are such loser attire, really. You know, it's one thing if it's a Saturday afternoon and you're going to make a date of doing your laundry together or going to the grocery store or running some errands, you know, that's different. But otherwise, that just, I've just seen it again and again and again. It's the sign of a loser. And I also look for the color brown. If I see somebody wearing a lot of brown, especially men with their footwear, especially men who wear blue jeans during the day, and they're not cowboys or construction workers, and they're still wearing them after 6 p.m., that sends me a really bad signal. And also, men who don't carry a handkerchief, that sends me a really bad signal. You know, every gentleman carries a second clean handkerchief for when she cries. You know, think about it. Okay, bye.